Hi everyone, and welcome back to another lab. In today's lab, we will cover how to configure and verify dynamic trunking. So in our previous lab, we have demonstrated how to configure and verify static trunking. So I left the link for this video for those who would like to tackle this first. In this lab, however, we will explore the configuration and verification of dynamic trunking between Cisco switches. So trunking allows us to carry traffic from multiple VLANs across a single link, providing efficient use of network resources and simplifying network management. And dynamic trunking protocol, or DTP, is a Cisco proprietary protocol used to negotiate trunk links between switches dynamically. By default, Cisco switches are set to negotiate trunking using DTP. However, understanding how to configure and verify dynamic trunking is essential for network engineers, as it enables automatic trunk negotiation and simplifies network deployment. So throughout this lab, we will learn how to configure switches to use dynamic trunking. We will verify trunk operations and troubleshoot common issues that may arise during configuration. And as you can see on the screen, I included a table that shows all the possible combinations of configuring two connected interfaces between two switches, switch 1 and switch 2, and what will be the result of each combination. So for example, if switch 1 is being configured statically with trunk, and switch 2 is also configured with trunk, and that is statically, then the output or the result of these two combination or configuration will be trunk. Also, we can see that if switch 1 is configured with access mode and the other end or switch 2 is configured with trunk, then we have an X, which means that the port is not going to operate in access mode or trunk mode. So that link will not be able to carry traffic. However, if one port is configured with dynamic desirable and the other port is configured with trunk, then the link will then become a trunk. And the same applies with dynamic auto. So if we then change this combination, so switch 1 uses trunk and switch 2 uses access, we get the same result. That is not going to form a trunk, or the link is not going to operate as an access, and therefore there will be no traffic across that link. And if the switch 1 is configured with access and switch 2 is configured with dynamic desirable or dynamic auto, then the link will still operate in access mode. So if then switch 1 is configured with dynamic desirable and switch 2 is also configured with dynamic desirable, so the result of this, we will form a trunk between both ends. And similarly with dynamic auto, if dynamic auto is being configured on switch 1 and dynamic desirable is configured on switch 2, then you will be able to form a trunk. However, if switch 1 and switch 2, both of them are configured with dynamic auto, then the port will remain in access mode. And the reason behind this is because none of the ports will actually initiate the trunking negotiation. So the lab objective of this lab is to configure and verify dynamic trunking between Cisco switches, and by the end of this lab, you should be able to understand the concept of dynamic trunking and its benefits in a network environment, and able to configure Cisco switches to use dynamic trunking protocol or DTP for automatic negotiation. And you should also be able to verify trunk operation and ensure that VLAN traffic is being forwarded correctly across trunk links. Finally, you also should be able to troubleshoot common issues related to dynamic trunking configuration, such as mismatched trunk modes or failed negotiation, etc., etc. So regarding the lab topology, as you can see on the screen, we have a couple of layers. We have the access layer, which is the lower half of the topology, and we have the distribution layer, which is the upper half of the topology. The lower half of the topology, or the access layer, is connected to the end devices. So we have PC1, PC2, and PC3. So we can see PC1 and PC2 are connected to switch 1. PC1 is part of the IT department and it resides in VLAN 10, whereas PC2 is part of VLAN 20 and it resides in the HR department. Similarly, on the other side, we have switch 2, and PC3 is connected to switch 2 as well as PC4. PC3 is part of the IT department and it resides in VLAN 10, and PC4 is part of the HR department and it resides in VLAN 20. So all these links, so fast Ethernet 01, fast Ethernet 02 on switch 1 and switch 2 will operate in access mode. And we can see that switch 1 and switch 2 are then interconnected with the distribution layer, which are switch 3 and switch 4. And all the links will operate in trunk mode, and we are going to configure these links to form a trunk dynamically. So with this being said, let's move to the switch VLAN table. So I'm going to scroll a little bit to the right, and as you can see, it's very self-explanatory. We have the device name, we can find switch 1, switch 2, switch 3, and switch 4. We can see the interface ID, and this table lists all the interfaces that we will be configuring in this lab and are the active interfaces. And we can see there is the interface mode, which defines the operation of each interface. So for example, Gig Ethernet 01, we know that is connected to switch 3, and that interface or this link will operate in trunk mode. And we are going to use the trunk auto on switch 1. However, on switch 3, we will be using trunk desirable. And we know based on the combination that we discussed earlier in the table, that this combination will or should give us the desired output that we want. And the both ends will form a trunk. And then we will only allow the VLANs in questions, and those VLANs, as you can see, are 10 and 20. On the other hand, we can find fast Ethernet 01 and fast Ethernet 02. Both interfaces will operate in access mode, and fast Ethernet 01 will be part of VLAN 10, whereas fast Ethernet 02 will be part of VLAN 20. The same method applies across switch 2, switch 3, and switch 4. If I then scroll a little bit down, we can find the SVI table, and on that table we can see we have a couple of devices. These are the distribution layer devices, switch 3 and switch 4. So switch 3 will have two SVI interfaces. Those are the SVI 10 and SVI 20. Each SVI will have its own IPv4 address, as you can read from the table, and the same applies for switch 4. So switch 3 will have VLAN or SVI 10, and that will have this IP address 192.168.10.3 with a /24 subnet mask. And the same applies for switch 4, VLAN 10 or SVI 10 with this IPv4 address 192.168.10.4/24. And finally, we will also configure SVI 20 on switch 3 and switch 4 with 192.168.20.3 IPv4 address. On switch 3 and on switch 4, we will configure SVI 20 with 192.168.20.4/24. Finally, we can find the host's IPv4 address table. And just to let you know that all PCs already have been pre-configured prior to this session. And this is just to save time, and we already have covered this in our previous labs. So PC1 on fast Ethernet 0 will have 192.168.10.10/24, and we know that this PC will reside in VLAN 10. Similarly with PC2, we'll have 192.168.20.10/24, and we know that PC2 is part of VLAN 20. Again, the same applies for PC3 and PC4. Next, let's talk about the lab task, where we are going to cover all the steps that is required for us to be able to accomplish this lab. So the first task is we will need to build the actual lab, whether we're going to do that virtually or physically, and then we would need to connect all the devices according to the topology. We then jump into each device and change the host name for each switch. And then after that, we move to step 3, where we will do some VLAN and SVI configuration, much like what we did in our previous lab. We then move to trunk configuration, and under this section, we have two subtasks. The first task, or the first subtask, we will tackle switch 1 and switch 2, and we are going to configure Gig Ethernet 01 and Gig Ethernet 02 to configure them dynamically using the auto option, and we will show you how you can do that. And then we will set the allowed VLANs to only allow VLANs 10 and 20, and then we will set the interface description, and we will also perform some in-flight checks to make sure that our configuration has been applied and we can read the output from the interface statistics to kind of like understand what is going on. And then we will move to step number 5, where we will then change the native VLAN from 1 to 10. And then we will do further verification after this. And then after this, we will then move to the second subtask, which we will then going to tackle switch 3 and switch 4. And this time we will configure 3 interfaces. We can see fast Ethernet 01 that is connecting switch 3 and switch 4. And then we have Gig Ethernet 01 and Gig Ethernet 02. And then we will set the encapsulation to use .1Q method. And then we move to step 2, where we are going to configure both interfaces, or actually the 3 interfaces, to use dynamic trunking, but this time we will use the desirable option. And then we will just follow the rest of the configuration that we have applied on switch 1 and switch 2. And then let's move to step 5, where we will do some configuration on our access ports. And we know that the access layer has switch 1 and switch 2. And we know that switch 1 has 2 interfaces. These are the fast Ethernet 01 and fast Ethernet 02. And both interfaces are connected to our end devices or end hosts. And these are the interfaces that will then operate in access mode. And we are going to assign each interface or each access interface with the appropriate VLAN. Next, we move to step number 6, where we need to do some end host configuration. And as I have mentioned earlier, we have already configured this or pre-configured this prior to the session, just to save some time. And if you obviously are going to build this lab yourself or using packettracer or using any other mean, then you would need to tackle this step. And then once you have done this, you can then move to step number 7, where we will need to perform some connectivity tests between devices within the same VLAN or the same network. So for instance, we will ping from PC1 to PC3 and PC2 to PC4. Then after that, we will test inter-VLAN communication. For instance, we want to make sure that PC1 is able to ping PC4. We will check if the ping is successful. If not, then why is not successful, and we can do further troubleshooting and we can explain why. Then we move to step number 9, where we are going to enable IP routing and repeat step number 8 if the ping has failed. And then move to the last step, which is step number 10. If the ping were successful and we have reachability and accessibility between both departments, then we can go ahead and save the configuration. Otherwise, we will need to do further troubleshooting. So this is the moment where I ask you to pause the video and give this a go yourself if you want to test your knowledge and skills. So in the video description, I included the lab task and the lab document so that you can download them and practice at your own pace. And I also included a 2 packet tracer labs. The first one is the pre-configuration, which is for those who want the lab to be ready to go for practice. And the other packet tracer file is the post-configuration, which is for those who want to verify their configuration against my configuration. So I'm going to tackle step number 2 from the lab task, and I'm going to log into each device and I will change the host name. I will do that quickly, guys. Okay, so step number 2 is done. Let's move to step number 3, where we will do some VLAN and SVI configuration. So we're going to configure VLANs first across all switches and then tackle SVI configuration on switch 3 and switch 4. And I'm also going to verify that as I go along. And to verify this, we would just need to issue show VLAN brief. And you can see that we have created a couple of VLANs on switch 1. And currently, there are no physical ports that have been assigned for each of these VLANs. Let's do the same thing on switch 2. And the same output on switch 2. Again, the same output on switch 3. And then finally, on switch 4, we can see that we also have created these 2 VLANs. And next, we can then configure the SVI interfaces on switch 3 and switch 4. So I'm going to go back to global config, interface VLAN 10, IP address 192.168.10.3, and the subnet mask is 255.255.255.0, which is /24. and do the same thing for VLAN 20. And the IP address will be 192.168.20.3/24. And we can do some in-flight checks. So I will say do show IP interface brief. And I only want to include the VLAN interfaces or SVIs. So I'm going to say include LAN. And you can see that we have VLAN 1 and VLAN 10 and VLAN 20. So VLAN 1 is there by default and currently is admin down. And you can see that VLAN 10 and 20 have been configured with the appropriate IPv4 address. Currently, you can see that status is in the up-down state, and the reason being is because these SVIs have not been assigned to any physical interface yet. So let's do the same thing on switch 4. So I will do the in-flight checks. So I'm going to say do show IP interface brief pipe include LAN. And we can see that we have configured these two SVIs according to the lab document. So next we will tackle the step number 4, where we are going to do trunk configuration. So I'm going to go back to switch 1 and switch 2. So I will go back to config or global config. And from here, I'm going to use the interface range command to configure two interfaces simultaneously. And here I'm going to say switch port mode dynamic auto. And I will allow only the VLANs in question. So I'm going to say switch port trunk allowed VLAN 10 and 20. Finally, I will configure the description under both interfaces. So I would say link to distribution switch. So let's do some in-flight checks. And to do this, you can issue the show run command pipe and section. And we can just copy this. /, and then I will include the asterisk to include everything. And you can see this is the current configuration under these two interfaces. And let's do further in-flight checks. So let's say show interface trunk. And currently there is no information or output. And the reason being is because we have set the switch port to operate in dynamic auto. And currently, and as we stand, there is no trunk that has been formed. And the only way to do that is by configuring the other end, which is switch 3 interface, Gig Ethernet 01 and Gig Ethernet 02, to either statically configure the interface to operate in trunk, or we use the desirable mode option. So the last in-flight checks that I want to perform is the show interface Gig Ethernet 0/1. and I supposed to actually include the switch port command. And in here, we can see that we have administratively changed that to dynamic auto, as you can see here. However, the current operational mode is set to static access mode. So this will change, as I mentioned earlier, if we configure the other end with either static trunk or desirable. So let's move into switch 2 and do the same thing. And I'm going to use the interface range command to include both interfaces. And I will set the switch port mode to dynamic auto, and then only allow the appropriate VLANs, which are 10 and 20. Finally, I will configure the description for both interfaces, and I would say link to distribution switch. Again, if I issue the show interface trunk, we get nothing. If I issue the show run pipe include or section, and then we include the interface ID, you can see this is the current configuration. And finally, if we say show interface gig ethernet 0/1 or 0/2, and again, I supposed to actually include the switch port command. And you can see that we have administratively configured it with dynamic auto. However, the current operational is set to static access. So the next step is to change the native VLAN from 1 to 10 across both trunk links, which are connected to the distribution layer. So I'm going to go back to the global config, and actually I'm going to do that on switch 1 first. I'm going to say switch port trunk native VLAN 10. I will do the same thing on switch 2. Say interface range gig ethernet 0/1-2. And I'm going to say switch port trunk native VLAN 10. So again, let's do in-flight checks. So I'll say show run pipe include or section. And you can see that we have set the switch port trunk native VLAN to 10. And just for the sake of it, I will do the same thing on switch 1. And just to let you know, guys, it's always good to do or to perform in-flight checks all the time. That will enhance your awareness of what's going on with your device, and you can catch up any mistakes if there is a human error or if there is something that doesn't sound right. And we have pretty much the same configuration on switch 1. Let's move into switch 3. And on switch 3 and switch 4, we will configure 3 interfaces. So I'm going to use again the interface range command. And the first thing that I'm going to do is set the switch port encapsulation to .1q just to force it. So I'm going to say switch port trunk encapsulation 1.1q. Next, I will change the switch port mode to dynamic desirable. And as soon as we hit that, we will get a lot of error messages, and that's because the native VLAN is mismatched between both ends, and that is understandable. So we're going to tackle that next. We will set the allowed VLAN on the trunk. So I'm going to say switch port trunk allowed VLAN 10 and 20. And then I'm going to set the interface description. So I will say interface, or actually, I would say interface range gig ethernet 0/1 and 2. And I will change the description to link to access switches. Link to access switch. That would do. Then move to interface fast ethernet 0/1. Do the same thing, change the description or create a description for the interface. And here I would say link to switch 4. So at this point, we can do in-flight checks. So let's do that quickly. I will say show interface trunk. And in here, we can see that the native VLAN is 1. The current status is in trunking or trunking mode. And the current encapsulation method is using .1q. And you can see here the mode is desirable. And that has been applied on fast ethernet 0/1, gig ethernet 0/1, and gig ethernet 0/2. The current allowed VLANs on that trunk are 10 and 20. Again, on all the trunks that are currently configured on the switch. Next, let's do the same on switch 4. So we configure the trunk encapsulation to force it to use .1q method. And then we're going to change the switch port mode to dynamic desirable. And we are going to allow VLAN 10 and 20 only on through that trunk. So we would say switch port trunk allowed VLAN 10 and 20. And then finally, we're going to set the interface description for gig ethernet 0/1 and 2. So we're going to say interface range gig ethernet 0/1-2 description link to access switch. And then let's say interface fast ethernet 0/1 description link to switch 3. Let's do the in-flight checks. So say show run interface, or sorry, show interface trunk. And we get similar output to switch 3. And if I say show run section, let's just copy you can see this is our current configuration on both interfaces, gig ethernet 0/1 and gig ethernet 0/2. The current description is linked to access switch. Same applies on under the interface gig ethernet 0/2. Both interfaces are only allowing VLAN 10 and 20. Both interfaces are using the .1q as the encapsulation method, and both interfaces are using the dynamic desirable. If I do the same thing, but for fast Ethernet 0.1, let's say fast. Actually, one second, if I... And here you can see that the current description is set to link to switch 3, and the rest of the configuration pretty much is identical on interface gig Ethernet 01 and gig Ethernet 02. Next, let's tackle the native VLAN. So I'm going to jump back on switch 3. Go back to global config and go back to the interface range gig Ethernet 0/1-2 fast Ethernet 0/1, and we would say switch port trunk native VLAN is 10, and let's do the same thing on switch 4. Now you can see that the port consistency has been restored. So if I say show interface trunk, you can see that the current native VLAN now is set to 10. And practically we have the same output, but let's go back to switch 1 and issue show interface trunk. If you remember last time we issued this command, we had an empty output, but this time we can see that there is actually a trunk that has been formed between switch 1 and switch 3, as well as switch 4. You can see that the current mode is set to auto. The encapsulation is negotiable, or has been using the negotiation protocol between both ends. Because there is the N there, and it using .1q. The current status of the interface is trunking, and the current native VLAN is 10. We can also see that the current or the allowed VLANs on both links are only 10 and 20 VLANs. Next, let's move to step number 5, where we will need to tackle the access port configuration. So we know on switch 1, we would need to perform some config changes on fast Ethernet 01 and 02. So let's do that now. So I'm going to go back to global config mode, and from there, I'll go to the interface config mode. And from here, I would say gig Ethernet fast Ethernet 0/1. And I will set the description link to PC1. Switch port mode access, switch port access VLAN 10. And let's do the same thing for fast Ethernet 02. And switch 1 is pretty much good to go. So I'm going to verify this by saying show VLAN brief. And you can hear, you can see here that fast Ethernet 01 is part of the IT department or VLAN 10. Fast Ethernet 02 is part of the HR department or VLAN 20. Next, let's do the same thing on switch 2. let's do in-flight checks. So show VLAN brief, and we get the same output as what we saw on switch one. Let's just include one for now. And you can see this is the current configuration that's been applied under the interface Fast Ethernet 01. If we do the same thing for Fast Ethernet 02, this is the current config that has been applied. Next, we can say show interface Fast Ethernet 0/1. And we're going to include the word switch port or the command switch port. And in here, we can see that the current name or the current interface name is Fast Ethernet 01. The switch port is being enabled. This means this port is operating at layer 2. And the current operational status is set to access. The current VLAN is set to 10. And you can use the rest of the output for further troubleshooting when needed. So next, let's tackle step number 6. And as I mentioned earlier, we already configured that. So what I'll do, I will go through each PC and I'll show you the IP configuration just for confirmation. So PC1, go to desktop and then command prompt and then issue ipconfig. And you can see the current IPv4 configuration. Do the same thing on PC2. And then repeat the same thing on PC4. And then finally PC3. Okay, so let's move to step number 7, where we will do some connectivity test. So we're going to initiate ping from PC1 to PC3. So I'm going to say ping 192.168.10.11. And we can reach PC3. Let's do the same thing between PC2 and PC4. And there is connectivity and reachability. Next, let's do the same thing, but for the inter VLAN communication. So we want to make sure that PC1 is able to ping PC4. So let's do this. So as you can see that the current test has failed, and the reason why it failed is because there is no routing being allowed on switch 3 and switch 4. So we understand that switch 3 and switch 4 are layer 2 and layer 3 capable. So it's a layer 3 switch. However, we will need to actually manually enable IP routing on both switches. So let's do that now. So I will exit one level, and from here I would say IP routing. I will end this and I'll save the config. Let's do the same thing on switch 4. Finally, let's retest this. And we can find there is a successful ping. And at this point in time, we have reachability between HR and IT department. And we can then tackle step number 10, where we can go through each device and save the configuration accordingly. So that's it, folks, for this video. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you never miss our future tutorials and tech insights. If you have any questions, comments, feel free to drop a comment below. I read all your comments and I'm here to assist you. Remember, consistency and hands-on practice are key to success. So stay curious, stay inspired, and until next time, peace.